Spring is a network operating system, and the clients and the servers can be on the same machine, can be on different nodes of a local area network. And in the Spring system, what they wanted to do was this idea of extensibility. They wanted to carry it to saying the client and the server should be impervious to where they are in the entire network. So the interaction should be freed, or in other words, the client-server interaction should be freed from the physical location of the clients and the servers. So for instance, in this picture, the clients and the servers are in the same machine. We've decided to replicate the servers in order to increase the availability, and now we have several copies of the servers, and the clients are dynamically routed to different servers for load distribution. And for those of you who are familiar with, you know, how services like Google work today, this is exactly what happens in services that we use on an everyday basis. When we access Google, our client requests are being routed to different servers, and this is the same sort of thing that is happening in the Spring system, that once you replicate the server, you want the client request to be routed to different servers depending on the physical proximity of the client to the servers, as well as the load that is currently being handled by one server versus another. Another variation of the same theme is where the server is not replicated, but the server is cached. For instance, if it's a web server, then there could be a proxy for the web server that is cached. And in that case, the client requests need not go to the origin web server, but it can go to the cached copies that are available. And so here again, this decision of routing a client request to a particular cached copy of the server is dynamically taken. Now, all of this sounds like magic in terms of how this client-server relationship is being dynamically orchestrated, whether they are on the same machine or whether we dynamically decide to replicate the servers and decide to route the request to different servers, or we want to cache the servers and route the client request to different cached copies. All of these are dynamic decisions that are taken. And how is this done? Well, that's the part that we're going to see next.